A student asked me if I can have a look at this MATLAB program where he's facing some problems. And it's an international student, so I'm trying to explain everything in English. And this program should somehow solve three differential equations. This is the main program. I think this is the code that I've got. This is some auxiliary function that does the calculation, and there are two text files that are, in my opinion, just copies of older versions of the main program and this calculation function. So let's have a look at this main program, run it, and then we see, okay, there's some problem here in line 11. The quite understandable error message is given here, and we can also really easily see what the problem is. So on the right side of this equation, we have a vector with three elements. All elements are zero. And then we try to put this into the zeros element of a variable. And so this index here, this is zero, and MATLAB tells us this is not allowed. The index must be a positive integer or must be logical value. So if I generate a variable called x and put three arbitrary numbers in there and try to call the zeros element of this variable, it will not work because of the same error message. There is no zeros element in this vector. MATLAB starts to count with one. So the first element is x1, this will work, and the second element and the third element and so on. So if I put a one here and try to call this line again, then the error message is different. It says now that left and right side cannot be put together because here we have an element with three, or a vector with three elements, and we put this into one element of this matrix here. So this won't work. If I say 1, 2, 3, this will work. Three numbers into the first three elements of this vector. This should work. If I try this, this runs without problems, but it would be simpler and easier to say just we put these three numbers into one element of this, into this variable here, and then just call this variable x here. Okay, so let's try this again. So now this line works. Now we have a problem in the next line, line 12, and this says that this function here trash returns a vector of length 1, but we should get back a vector of length 3 because we put three elements inside this function, so we should get back three numbers here, but we just get 1. So if we run it again, of course problem is not solved by itself. So let's see what this function trash does. Take a look at this function. It gets the time and it gets this x. The time here is called t range. So we calculate trash from t range and from x. Now we see we even get back zero elements. We should get back three, but there's nothing, just an empty array. So let's take a look what the function does. And then we see, okay, we get back this variable here. This variable is defined here, and it's really a vector of three elements. So if I try to call this, I mean, this is the nice thing in MATLAB that you can have a look at all the variables at all the time. So let's see what's inside here. I think this will not work now. Yes, because it's some internal, some local variable inside this function. There are lots of global variables here, which is, in my opinion, not a good style of programming. I would try to get rid of all these global variables. So let's run this internal function here and see what it does and take a look here. And then we see, okay, this is an empty variable, this is an empty variable, this is an empty variable, and that's why what we get back from the function is also empty. So then let's see, for example, where is this first function or this first variable calculated? It's calculated here. So f1 has a value. Okay, f2 has no value. Okay, f2 is empty. Why is f2 empty? Where is f2 calculated? And then we see that here it's commented out. F2 has no value, and that's why f2 is just empty. So I would comment this back in again, save and run again. We still have the same problem. Now it says, okay, we already get back two numbers. Not too bad, not too bad, but will probably still not solve our problem. So let's run this trash function again. Again, everything is empty. So let's get back to the beginning. We evaluate this and see what it does. So F1 has a value, F2 also has a value, F4 has no value. Why has F4 no value? Because we calculate F4 here. And maybe F4 has gotten a value of 8 here, but this value is overwritten here. So let's take a look inside this function and we see Q100 is empty. Why is Q100 empty? Because we calculate Q100 here. So F1, F3 has some value, T100 has a value, but T2 probably has no value. And T2 has no value because we calculate T2 here, and probably this P2 has no value. So P2 is nowhere defined, so we should define P2 here. I don't know what P2 should be. I will just give it a value of 2. So again, let's see what it does and run this here. This is still empty. F4 is still empty. And so there are obviously many, very many problems in this code. So F4 is calculated here in this line. Q100 is still empty because Q100 is calculated here. F1 has a value, F3 has a value. T100 has a value, but T2 still has no value because P2 has now a value. We have just set this, but X2 has no value. So X2 is not set, then of course X2 cannot have any value. So we will just set X2, and again, I don't know what X2 is, just set it to 2. I have no clue what the program does, I'm just trying to fix the errors here. So, okay, then interestingly, we get another nice error message in line 8 of this trash function. So here is a nice calculation, and obviously I think what is meant here is that we CP is some value, some coefficient for something, and T2 and T1 are maybe some temperatures. And I think what is meant here is that we multiply this coefficient with the difference of these two temperatures. But what is written here is that it's like this is a vector or a matrix, and we call this element out of this vector or matrix. And I think that does not make sense. And that's why, again, we get the same error message that the array indices, this one here, this should be a positive integer or some logical value. So we change this by multiplication and save it and run it again. And then it seems to work. So again, if I try to call the this trash function, then we get back three values. This seems to make sense. But now the problem is that this plotting command here does not make any sense at all, because there is no variable called lowercase x. And I think maybe what is meant here that we are trying to plot this solution, so the time from the solution and the y values of the solution. So let's do it again, and then we see, okay, now we get back some solution. I don't have any idea what the three lines mean in the solution, and I think these lines are also just defined by 2 points, because the time value for the solution, no, there are many points, but the time range that we give therein, okay, this is defined by these two numbers. So this is maybe the solution of this program problem or this program. At least all the semantic and syntactic errors and mistakes are fixed in this program. Still, I have no clue if the program does what it should do.